Hey guys, and welcome to Well Weekly with Mist. And today's a great day for me to record this video, I guess. I was gonna wait till Sunday, is usually when I do these Well Weekly videos, because I post them on Mondays. This week we're doing it on Saturday because it just so happens that no one can really get into the game today. This will be, you know, past news by the time you watch this in a couple of days, but today there's been attacks on the servers all day. It was also reported that the attackers actually attacked other stuff prior, because I like slept into like fucking almost noon today, so I noticed the WoW stuff, but prior to that they had attacked Amazon. Twitter was down for a bit. Wikipedia, I guess they had attacked the day before. And then when they took WoW servers down, they also took Overwatch down. I don't know for how long, because I'm not really an Overwatch player. But because I am a huge WoW addict, I do run the forum that I keep everyone informed. We also have the community over on Battle.net that I keep everyone informed when stuff like this happens. So yeah, if you want to join those, you're more than welcome. Forum is www.sinsofinsanity.com, and the community forum, or the community pages for the Battle.net, you would honestly be better off just going to my Twitch page, which is twitch.tv/MrDarkness. In that page, there's a list of links, and you'll see the Blizzard Battle.net community link in there. So yeah, that is, well, I guess that's how we're starting the intro of this video. So hopefully you got to play the game on Saturday. It is 5:30 my time right now, which is Mountain Time. And they've been down since, well, I noticed it starting to happen at noon, but that's when I got to the computer, so it could have been happening before that. It's, to be honest, out of all the attacks I've seen on Blizzard servers in the past, this one's actually the longest one, which is funny because over on Twitter, people are basically saying that he's not as good as other attacks have been, but, you know, to be honest, whether he's copying a code or not, he's, you know, making it last longer than the others have. So it has been going on for quite a while, you know, 6 hours so far. And just a little side note here before we get over to the news part. In an earlier video, actually it would have just been maybe a few days ago, I had done a video. It was one of the BFA videos. It was for the Rank 3 Crucible of Flame. And in that video, because like many, this one's kind of the exception. I usually stick to news topics when it comes to WoW Weekly. But in all my other videos, I kind of ramble about whatever while you're watching me do stuff. Because, you know, I'm a streamer, right? I'm used to that. You know, I talk about whatever comes to mind while you're watching me do whatever content the video's for, right? So in that video for the Crucible of Flame Rank 3, near the end, I had started talking about how I had tried the glyph for the Druid Boomkin form. This is it right here. I just thought I would point that out because when I talk about it in that video, I already have taken the glyph off because I decided I didn't want it. So you don't actually see what I was referring to, but here you do. So this is it. The the night elf form that you see and the glimmer and all that, that is the glyph that takes your boomkin away and puts you in this form. And many, many people use it. And that's why I thought I would give it a go. It does look cool, but looks are deceiving, man, because when you've been playing a boomkin for so long, it took me a matter of 5 minutes to lose the, oh, this is cool vibe and want it off. But of course, I had to, I think you have to wait till you hit up a city. Plus, I was in a time dungeon. I wasn't going to do it while we're fucking trying to beat a score. But basically, the reason I chose not to keep it is because it just felt wrong. You know, I like my night elf form and all. And it's cool that, I guess, in a sense, you can show off your transmog. I say in a sense because you're like glimmering, right? That's not your true transmog. You can't really totally tell what your transmog is, you know, when you're pretty much all white. But I imagine that's the reason people use it, though, because one of the biggest things with a druid is you work to get this transmog that no one ever sees because you're a shapeshifter. Whether you're playing a cat or a boomkin or, you know, bear, you're pretty much always shapeshifted. The only ones that aren't are resto, and it's probably why there's a lot of resto druids out there, because to be honest, I would almost bank on the fact that they decide to go resto because it's the one form they can show their fucking transmog off in while they're fighting. I would bet you anything that's the biggest reason people go resto. Like, guaranteed for a druid. So yeah, I just thought I'd, you know, let you know that that was that. I can't remember what the name of the glyph is, but I'll put it in the description. I'll look it up after I do the edit on this video, just in case you do want this glyph. So definitely check the description and I'll list the name of the glyph in there. And yeah, if you've been playing a boomkin for as long as I have, you'll probably understand why it was a quick glyph. Just because it felt so weird to not be in boomkin. I think it would have been maybe a different thing if it had altered the boomkin look. But for me, I guess the biggest part was my armorkin, which is a thing me and the stream call it. It's your buff that puts the armor on your boomkin. But not seeing that, like, yeah, I would trigger that and I would just see this. And that's what made me instantly decide to swap back to the way I was. Because, like, I cannot just not see that form. Like, that form is fucking awesome. So yeah, it's it looks great for looks, but, you know, all in all, yeah, I definitely prefer my boomkin. So anyway, went a little on regarding that, but I just thought I'd let you guys know about that. Okay, so on for our news. Okay, so we will start with the BFA stuff. This past week was time walking. I went and did that. We did it on stream. I got absolutely nothing. I got a 415. I don't even know, because once I realize it's 415, unless it's got amazing stats with it, I just don't care because all my gear is above 415. I need stuff to basically be like between 430 and 440 for it to be an upgrade. So yeah, that was a flop, but whatever. Got my badges anyway. So So yeah, this coming up week, and actually I did mention that we were going to stay active with the mythics. I have not done mine yet, but since I'm recording this video today due to the servers being down at the moment, that's going to give me a little more time tomorrow. Because tomorrow, like Sundays, I usually use the time for these videos. And ironically, it might not seem like it, but ironically, these WoW Weekly videos I do, they take the longest out of all the videos I do. Every week, I spend probably a good 3 hours doing the WoW Weekly video. And that's like, you know, recording the content in the voice, which I typically add in later. And, because I record the content ahead of time. And then I wait till the very end of the week. That way we get all the current news, right? And then the time of saving it and all that. So it generally takes quite a bit of time. So that gives me time to actually do the mythics tomorrow. So we haven't done that yet, but I will. I did open my weekly cache from the mythic last week. It was garbage. It was a 430 belt. I already had a 430. It had exactly the same stats. And yeah, so unfortunately that was a wipe. Okay, so for this week's new events in BFA, we have the Harvest Festival will start this week. It's going to run for 1 week. So it's if you got, you know, achievements or whatnot or things you want to get out of the Harvest Festival, it's, you know, as much as I hate to say it, it's a good time to maybe step away from Classic for a week because this only lasts for 1 week. If you don't, whatever, stay in Classic. You're good to go. Like, Harvest Festival doesn't really affect me. I have all the achievements. I just gotta see if they're gonna be putting out pets, but Blizzard doesn't like to announce any of that shit for these events until, like, the day it fucking drops, right? So I will post a comment if there's some new pets. So, you know, if you're interested in that, come back to the video on Tuesday or something, and, you know, I don't know if there will be. Also, we will have the Arena Skirmish, and there will also be Dark Moon going on. So, all in all, if it wasn't for Dark Moon, I probably wouldn't be doing much in BFA this week, because I don't imagine much new is going to be there for Harvest. And I don't really do the Arena Skirmish events. But no matter what's ever going on, I always use Dark Moon to take advantage of getting the alts up. And I really kind of want to do that this time too, because with me being in Classic and, you know, actually really enjoying Classic, I need to kind of take advantage of leveling the alts on the days that have perks. So I'm not saying we're gonna be in BFA like, you know, a shitload. I don't even know if I'll stream it because it's just leveling alts, right? I may just do that on days off or something. So it'll just be the regular stream schedule, you know, Tuesdays and Wednesdays I'm in BFA because I do the mount runs and the transmog runs, and the rest of the days it's gonna be Classic. I see no reason to wipe the Classic out of the streams for something like I said, leveling alts. I've, you know, on average I hate really leveling characters on stream anyway because it's kind of like boring content to watch, because, like, let's get serious, WoW is not the most entertaining game to watch as a stream. It's entertaining for a YouTube video, because a YouTube video typically only lasts, you know, let's say 5 minutes to maybe an hour, right? So, you know, versus a 8-hour stream or a 12-hour stream. So, yeah. So, yeah, long story short, we'll be in BFA for a couple of days and the rest will be classic. And that is all the events for BFA. And there's really has not been anything for news. It's been kind of blah for the patch news. I've been waiting so that I can start prepping a video for the next patch for BFA. And they're just so busy in Classic right now that, you know, nothing's really new. So we are done with this section. Let's move on to Classic news. Okay, so on to Classic news. So Classic, as you can see, this is a different character for this week's video. This is a new one I created because my best friend decided he wanted to give Classic a go. So we did a night of playing Classic. And I created this character. So this is my mage, Frost, and low level right now. What you're seeing basically a recording I did right before we logged out and we haven't gone back over, because I'm probably just going to keep this character for when he decides he wants to play WoW. That way we're still the same level. I can always, like, you know, if I don't feel like waiting, I can always just make another character. This one's only a level 8 or whatever. I don't know. Now, it's really weird because when it comes to the gnomes, I never made a gnome out of, like, my 15 years of playing WoW. It wasn't until BFA, just shortly before they released the Mechagon, because the Mechagon area was getting a lot of gnome hype for obvious reasons, right? So I started looking at gnome characters, and they are so fucking adorable. They are so cute. I have a bunch in Classic now. Yeah, I don't know why. I never, like, why did it take 15 years for me to consider making a gnome? But yeah, they are cute. I have this mage. I also made a gnome rogue. I have a gnome warlock. Yeah, they are just super adorable. Yeah. So this one is going the route of tailoring. I chose that because, like I said, I was grouped up with my best friend. So, of course, I want to be able to make us bags. And yeah. So yeah. Can't remember what I put with it. Probably enchanting. Yeah, I believe it was enchanting. Because that's usually what I do. If I go tailoring, typically, I'm an enchanter on that character. That's kind of the combo I like to do with tailoring. And it's honestly a really good combination to do because you're making cloth items, right? So assuming it's not just bags and you're making, you know, actual gear, then you just use that gear you're creating to disenchant for your enchanting. It's really a great combination. So if you are looking for another, maybe an alt, or maybe you haven't started yet and you're looking for, you know, maybe doing tailoring or something, stick enchanting with it, because it never fails. The first time I went that method was back in BC. It's when I brought my first alt into the picture, because my main back in vanilla was herbs and enchanting. And then when inscription came into the picture, I took the herbs off, put inscription, and I had my alchemist supplying me with herbs for that profession. Then when the alt came into the picture, which was a lock, I made that enchanting and tailoring, because I wanted a tailorer, right? So yeah. And the reason for the enchanting, because you're probably wondering, because I had the main as an enchanter, is because the alt was a horde character. So I always mained an alliance, but in BC they brought out the Blood Elves, which finally gave some sort of appeal for me over on the Horde side. Because, like, to be perfectly honest, if it wasn't for Blood Elves, I'd probably never have made a Horde character at all, ever. Just saying. Like, Druid's my favorite, and I refuse to make one over there because of them being torn. Of course, talking classic here. Like, if you're over in BFA, you got a few more, but it took a while for that to be a thing. You know, it took a while before they brought the trolls in as druids, and, well, Zandalari troll druids is a brand new thing that came out in this, you know, in the BFA expansion, so. Okay, so on to news before I start rambling a little too much here. Not like, it is news, but it actually happened during my last edit, like as I was editing last week's video, this all happened. But this past week, there have been some reg kills. There is a guild on EU side, and they're called Apes. They did the world first on reg, and then after they cleared Molten Core, they went into Onyxia, and they did a world first over there. So yeah, in a sense, they've already beat the game. So that makes me kind of, I don't know, I'm kind of worried with that one, to be honest. Before I get into that, I just want to say that, you know, later on in the week, I was watching a soda stream because I fucking love watching Soda Pop and stream. And he did a World 7th. So, World 7th and Server 2nd. Another thing I'd like to add is they are doing a thing where if you get to level 60 on Classic and you don't have a BFA account, you get an instant boost. And that boost is a 110. So yeah. They are not very up on the details, but I'm just going to put it out there that, like, 99.9% chance that if you already have an account, you're not getting that boost. They never give us shit, right? So not confirmed, but I'm, like, almost 100% sure that we'll get nothing. Usually those are to bring new players in, not to give old players free stuff. So, okay, and that's basically all the news there. So, yeah, I don't know. Not a whole lot going on this week. But that's okay. I actually really like the weeks where I can do a shorter WoW video for you guys, like on the WoW Weekly, because we do generally cover a lot of stuff every week. So it's nice to have kind of that slower week where there's not a whole lot going on. Yeah. So the only thing I really have left for you, and it's something I've talked about in stream, but I know not all the people that watch the YouTube videos come to the stream, so we will discuss it here too. But my biggest topic this past week has been, now that people have cleared Molten Core, you know, people are 60, people are clearing Molten Core, Onyxia, I do believe, is still the rare one where not a whole lot of people have cleared, but they'll get there. They'll get there. So where does that leave us? If people are already clearing that, you know, we gonna see a patch soon? You know, are we gonna see Classic Plus stuff? And what do you guys think of the Classic Plus idea? I am iffy about it, you know, like I like it and then I don't like it. I like it because, You know, as someone who has played the game for 15 years, it would be nice to have something new. You know, something that maybe I haven't seen before. But then on the other side of things, once you start adding new things, you're fucking up classic. It's no longer classic WoW. It's, you know, it's this, you know, classic WoW with expansion, you know, deal, right? I don't even know what you'd call it at that point, because it's not even really an expansion. I don't know. So, I'm not totally sure what I think about that. I think it could royally fuck up Classic. And for other topics, you know, that's all I really have. There's been some streamer drama. I typically don't talk about the streamer drama, mainly because I really don't give a shit about it most days. You know, they can do their own thing. For the most part, I just hear about it. I don't really take part in it. So I really got not much else. As for goals, basically my goals for this week is I would like to get my druid to level 30. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, haven't had a whole lot of time or chance to be able to do that today because the servers have been having attacks all day. But it is starting to get later. I should be able to maybe log on soon here and stay on. I haven't tried at all. Like, you know, basically when I got up, people were already talking about servers having issues. And right away, I'm like, oh, it's got to be an attack on Blizzard. And so did my research and, you know, yeah, it was. Because generally, if you see a lot of people having an issue, yeah. So, I'll probably get some leveling done tomorrow. Well, actually, I'll probably get some done tonight. I've been seeing my friends popping back in there as I've been editing this video. So it might be solid. We'll see. It's not, you know, not confirmed that they can stay in there yet, because it's people been logging on and then off and then on and off. And yeah. So I'm kind of just waiting till it's stable. I don't want to be logging on and then off. And yeah, I just want to have it stable enough so that I feel comfortable starting up my stream and all that. So, for the goals, I want to hit level 30 with my druid. And we did some dungeons last night, so I went in, did Black Fathom Deeps, I guess. That's what they call it in the quest log, but like for 15 years, I've been calling that place Black Fathom Depths. So, you know, let me know. Another little question for my YouTube fans here is, what do you call it? Like, you know, did you call it Depths too, or did you always call it Deeps? Like, yeah, when I read it in the quest log, and it does actually say, like, D-E-E-P-S, right? So that was really weird. But anyway, went and did that dungeon, and then went and did Stockades after. Both went really well. And tonight, the plan is Gnomes and... I think there was one we were going to do after. Oh, yeah, we were going to go black. We were going to go back to Black Fathom Depths because we all had a quest there that didn't get complete because they're, like, you know, sometimes when everyone's on the same quest, there's just not enough mobs, you know. So we're just going to go back there just to finish the quests up. So yeah, that should get me at least a level going back into Black Fathom and then into Gnomes. I think we'll do Black Fathom first because it's the lower level one. I believe Gnomes is kind of closer to the 30 merc for level. So, you know, if, you know, for example, if I level and Black Fathom's quests aren't done, those quests could go gray. You know, they're still yellow for me, so they'd go green. But the people that went with me, they're higher level than me. They're like level fucking 30. So I'm sure that quest is already green for them. So if they level, that quest could be gray. So yeah, 30 is the first goal. And then the second goal is gonna be to level some alts in BFA. I do have, trying to remember what I have over there. What we'll do as a goal is we'll aim for 5 levels, because I am still playing classic, right? We don't want to aim too terribly high, because I do have, you know, classic that I'll be in and work. So we'll do 5 levels as a goal. So 5 levels on an alt for the Dark Moon. And I think that's it. I guess Mythic would be another goal. My highest completed in time at the moment is an 8, so we'll aim for a 9. See if I can get a 9 done. I believe I have done a 9, but I don't think it was in time. Yeah, I don't think I passed the time on it. So yeah, that'll be our goal, to pass the time on a Mythic plus 9. Okay, unmuted the audio there for a bit for you guys. Well, a minute, in case you were curious what she was dancing to. But yeah, that concludes today's episode. That is all I have for you guys. So yeah, like I said, not a whole lot of news for BFA, not a whole lot for Classic. Just a chill week, pretty much. And also, I just a reminder, I will put the glyph name for the druid glyph I was referring to in the BFA section. And I hope you have a fun time playing Classic. Let me know what level you are. We're ready to approach week 3, I believe. So let's see what everyone's level is. Mine at the moment of recording this, which is Saturday night on September 7th, I just dinged 26 last night, so right at the beginning at level 26, which isn't too bad in my mind, because I'm not rushing. I took 2 days off of Classic to go do mount runs and transmog stuff and time walking over in BFA for this past week. So all in all, I think we're doing pretty okay. And just before I leave, because I usually like to let you guys know what's coming up on the channel for YouTube for the week, it's gonna be some old videos. I only really had a couple of classic videos for you guys, which are posted by now. So, they're the two druid forms. One was bear, one was water. I do have some more videos in the works. They just probably won't get posted this coming up week because they need to still get edited. So it is going to be some BFA how-to videos for achievements and stuff. So if that interests you, if you still play BFA, then feel free to check those out. And if not, we'll see you next Monday on the next WoW Weekly with Mist. And one last thing before I go. I am perfectly aware that this is laggy. So if you guys are noticing that the running's a little laggy, I'm completely aware of that. I gotta go into the settings, see what's going on, because streams have been fine and the BFA recordings are fine. And in this particular video, my OBS was overloading. It kept giving me an overload issue while I was doing it. And I'm like, you know, who the fuck cares? It's going to be a short video. So I really, at that time, I was like, let's just roll with it, see how it goes. So I do see the lag, guys. I am going to fix that. The next week's classic portion will be better. The week before was fine, so I'm not totally sure. Maybe OBS was just having a hiccup that particular day. But I'm going to drop the settings down a bit for the recording aspect anyway. And don't worry, it won't affect streams. I'm not gonna change a thing with the streams. Recording and streams have like different settings, different ways you gotta do things to get the proper quality. So, yeah, and it could be the game too. I didn't change a single thing with the default settings, so maybe the settings are just on really high on classic. So I'll go into there and that might be it as well. So yeah, that's all I have for you guys. Hope you enjoyed. I know it was like another day of like, we've had these days before where I'm all happy that we don't have a whole lot of news and I can have a nice short video and then I still run it at the half hour point. I realize that, I know, and I see that we're, you know, getting close to the 40 minutes. Yeah, that's what you get for, watching WoW Weekly with Mist. Anyway, have a good one, guys. See you in the next one. Bye.